doing good, Drishti. How are you doing?
All well. So first of all, I'm going to say that, you know, Ashram being the first web series that I've ever binge watched. First. Okay. It's so intriguing.
I don't know whether to feel very ecstatic and happy alone. I mean, thank you so much for saying that. That's a huge compliment.
And honestly, कहते हैं ना कि ट्रेलर से पता चलता है कि क्या होने वाला है. तो पार्ट वन भी जब मैंने देखा तो ट्रेलर देख के आई गॉट इंट्रीग्ड एंड वॉच द एंटायर थिंग. एंड नाउ पार्ट टू का भी मैंने ट्रेलर देख लिया है. एंड लाइक यू सेड दैट यू नो इट्स गेटिंग इवन मोर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड एंड ऑफ कोर्स इट इज सो इंट्रीगिंग. लुकिंग एट द एंटायर कॉन्सेप्ट आफ्टर आश्रम वॉज रिलीज्ड, whoever has watched it was kept telling me, kept commenting on the videos as well that kab aayega part 2. Tell me, how did people come up to you and what did they tell you about the entire web series? Because I've heard really good stuff.
Yeah, so they, whosoever I've spoken to has loved it. My family loved it, my extended relatives and all loved it. And because we've all found ourselves in similar situations at some point in our life, so I think it's a very relatable subject. It made them all nostalgic. There were some people who called me up and said, oh fish, you know, this can happen to us. And they've, and in fact there was one person who called me and said, this is what's happening in my family. And we went on to have a long conversation about what I have seen in my family and what that person is going through and in theirs. And you know, cue for this, because I would really want them to see it and to really understand what's going on. And so yeah, I mean, I've had all sorts of reactions come to towards me. And I think Ashram is one of the series that I've been stopped on the road the maximum time by people to be asked as to when is the second season coming up. You know, like literally people have stopped me on road, taken U-turns, and when I go for a walk, they've come, you know, come hunting me just to ask, okay, hi ma'am, when is Ashram 2 coming out? So that's been quite an experience. And we've been very overwhelmed with the kind of love and support that we received for the first season. We just hope that we continue to entertain the audiences and make them as proud of the series in the second one as well.
You know, in the last interview when we were talking of Ashram only, I guess, and I told you that my grandmom always kept doing all of this and kept, calling pundits home. And I wish she could have watched this web series. But do you think that it's high time that people don't blindly start following certain things unless they know about it, you know, as far, there's knowledge required, yeah.
Of course, it's high time, but I think, you know, steps like these are... is what would probably make a difference in the coming years. It's not something that you can change overnight, you know. Yeah. It's something that will change from generation to generation. And I'm hoping that the newer generation is far more aware, far more self-reliant. Because jab khud mein self-belief kam hoti hai, that's when you resort to finding faith in other people and then giving them complete power over yourself. I don't have a problem with having faith in a symbol of God in your eyes. Yeah, or, you know, having faith in another human being. That's not the problem. The problem is having blind faith, as you said. And to not trust yourself or your instincts. And to empower somebody completely to take full advantage of you or of your loved ones. You know, I think that is very scary. So, and usme aap कर्म को छोड़ के खाली धर्म के नाम पे काम करने लग जाते हैं
जी.
इनफैक्ट हमारे बाबा जी ही थे जो एकदम बोलते थे कि इफ यू टेकन यू नो रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी लाइक यू चोजन द वैवाहिक जीवन यूज टू से देन कर्म इज योर मेन रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. हर वक्त यहाँ साधना करने तुम नहीं आ सकते. उसके लिए मैंने अपनी ये साधु की लाइफ चुनी है, यू नो, जहाँ मैं साधना रोज कर सकता हूँ. तुम्हें काम करने की जरूरत है क्योंकि तुमने एक यू नो सामाजिक जीवन चूज किया है और तुम्हारी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज हैं उस लाइफ में. सो देर आर पीपल हु विल शो यू द राइट वे ऑल्सो, बट एज एन इंडिविजुअल फॉर यू टू नो व्हाट्स राइट एंड रॉन्ग यू नीड टू हैव योर सेंसिबिलिटीज अलाइव एंड एक्टिव.
Also, do you think that there's this डर जो लोगों में रहता है कभी कभी, you know, कुछ चीजें हो नहीं पाती लाइफ में, you know, you have this fear कि ये नहीं होगा वो नहीं होगा, and the last thing that you do is depend on all of these, even in terms of wearing different stones or changing your name for the matter of fact, that's what people believe in. Do you have an opinion on that as well? Do you think that it's weird?
So yeah, see, as I said, you know, I believe there's a science behind everything, because I come from a family where I've seen this all my life as well. You know, kundli dikhana, janampatri dikhana, kisi pandit ko refer karna, stones pehna. Even I'm wearing the diamond, to be very honest, right now. And that's also for astrological reasons, to be very honest. Okay, I won't lie. And I take it off, I wear it sometimes, I don't wear it sometimes. When I'm working, I'm working. I don't remember it. So I'm not somebody who's head-on believing in this.
Haan,
but at the same point in time, I'm not someone who will say, ki, nahin, main toh nahin pehnungi. You know, it's there. Mujhe pata hai ki mera kaam aur meri mehnat aur mera talent mujhe kahin leke jayega. There is no substitute of that. And as long as you're working hard and as long as your intentions are good, nothing can steer you away from your destiny or from your aim, you know. You will get there. Maybe there will be hurdles. Maybe there will be problems. There will be some roadblocks. But if you work hard enough, you can achieve anything that you really want, you know, and in the right way. You don't have to necessarily resort to outside help. Having said that, I don't think that if people choose to change their names or choose to, you know, change their spellings or whatever, or wear stones or anything which aids them and makes them feel better, great, do it. As long as it's not harming anyone or it's not harming your own self-interest, so you're not going completely berserk over it. That cannot become your focal point. Your work, your talent, you actively working towards your goal is supposed to be the main thing.
So if I'm not wrong, it's releasing on the 11th, right? 11th of November. So I'm without a doubt, it's obviously a bomber of a web series, and the best part is it's free on MX Player. Yay!
What more? Yippee!
Thank you for pointing
that out.
But also, since I have this time with you, I'm going to quickly talk to you about your relationship with food, okay? So I'm going to ask you like 5 quick questions so that, you know, this interview has two parts going up then. Yay, everyone will be happy. Okay, so to start off with, tell me the weirdest thing that you've ever had in your life.
The weirdest? Wow. I can't remember. I wasn't prepared for this question, yeah.
Something that you tried outside.
There was some... So I don't do well with prawns. Mm. Okay. Mm. And there was this one time that they were smelling great and I was on normal, you know, Indian food, like the basic Indian food for a very, very long time. And I was just dying to have something spicy and they looked very spicy.
Mm.
But the moment I had them, I think... The taste I'll never forget. From that day on, I've stopped having prawns, you know. Like, it was the most delicious looking dish in 1 minute. And the second minute, it was like the most, you know, like it was too bad for me.
I can only imagine. Okay, so like fashion trends keep changing. There are also diet trends that keep coming in. There's sometimes keto, blood group, and I don't know what not I hear of. Anything that you tried your hands on?
Very recently, I tried intermittent fasting. Very, very recent. I don't do diets very well because the moment someone tells me that you're not supposed to have something, I'll only want to have that. You know, and I like to have my meals every 2 hours and I have small meals every 2 hours. I've been working with that for a very, very long time. Plus, I'm not someone who really restricts myself to a certain kind of diet ever. So this time I did try intermittent fasting and well, I mean, I've heard people do wonders with it. It didn't really work for me. So I stopped after 5-6 days.
Also, you know, there are two types of chicks that I know. One is like, okay, if they don't get their food on time, and the other one has really bad mood swings. Which one are you? So tell me, how do you happen to behave when you don't get your food on time?
Arey, I'm like the cranky little child, yeah. Like, wo bachpan mein jaise maa nahi bolti thi, isko jab bhi roti hai, chillati hai, isko bhook lag rahi hai. My friends say that about me now. Like, can you believe that? My mother, even if I would be irritated, the first thing my mother as a child would tell me is, "Usko bhook lag rahi hai." Now my friends know me very well. The moment I'm hungry, the first question, or the moment I'm angry or upset or irritated, they ask me is, "Are you hungry? When was the last time you ate?" So yeah, I become quite obnoxious when I'm hungry. My mind stops working.
Also, tell me your favorite restaurant and your favorite cuisine.
So my favorite restaurant is Butler in the Bailey. It's quite near Prithvi in Juhu. And that's because it's run by a very, very, very dear friend of mine. Plus, the food is amazing and the service is beautiful. So I have a special corner for that restaurant. And the cuisine, generally, I love continental and Mexican food.
Mm-hmm. Okay, lastly, a food tip that you would want to give to all these youngsters nowadays, because sab kuch na internet pe dekh ke we start trying it at home. There are a lot of girls who are going into keto without even knowing or studying. So a tip that you would want to give everyone?
I think listen to your body. And it's very important. Your body tells you exactly what it needs, when it needs it. And we have to develop a way of do it as a practice to make a relationship with it and to listen to it. There are times we eat when we don't really need food or we're not really hungry. There are times where we have sweet cravings when your body is not really requiring that. Or there are times when you overindulge in a diet when you're absolutely fine and you could have, had a normal diet and done exactly the same thing to your weight or to your overall look. I don't think starving yourself makes you look any more attractive, because if you're eating the right kind of healthy food in the right intervals, it's going to do exactly the same thing to your body without you having to undergo any pain. It's quite possible. So for that, it's important to start listening to yourself and your body.
Lovely. So I'm going to just say that, thank you for telling me everything. And like for closures, what is it that you want to say to everybody who's been loving Ashram, who's been loving your work, not only in Ashram, but otherwise also?
Well, I'll just say thank you so much for giving me so much love and appreciation, for being patient with me and for supporting me. I am work in progress and I'm really trying to, up my skill set every other day, and I hope you would see more interesting work come out from my side. And while we are entertaining you, Ashram is coming out on the 11th of November, and thank you so much for giving the first part so much love and support and appreciation. We are waiting for you to see the second season and to love it as much. And I'm very sure that it will entertain you fully and leave you completely static. So don't forget our date with you on the 11th of November.
So thank you so much, Arupriya. This was lovely. Hoping to see you soon. And I must say, before I leave, your skin looks lovely. You are glowing, touch wood.
Thank you. So are you, by the way.
Thank you. Cat. I have many of them. Cat. They were meowing all the time.
Oh, cute. Oh God, what's her name?
This name is Tiki.
Tiki. Hi, Tiki.
Oh my. Anyway, thank you so much. Hoping to see you soon.
Take care.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.